In the case of right-handed forehand stroke, weight transfer occurs from right foot to left foot in any stance. This movement shows forward swing. Federer's swings in three stances look like each other. Even in the neutral stance, Federer's center of gravity is static, not moving forward. However, in the case of a forehand stroke, using strong linear momentum, the center of gravity moves forward along the weight transfer in the neutral stance. Wozniak shows strong linear momentum in a forehand stroke. The center of gravity in her swing moves forward. Moving distance of Dimitrov in his swing is shorter than that of Wozniak because he used centrifugal force in his swing. For using centrifugal force in forehand stroke, the center of gravity must be static. In Dimitrov's swing, non-moving center of gravity appears in the middle of forward swing. In the case of Federer's forehand swing, the center of gravity is constant throughout the entire forward swing. In the case of Wozniak, the center of gravity moves forward along the eighth shift. The base bulletin makes it easy to understand the movement of center of gravity. The center of gravity gets static in the middle of forward swing. This is the point at which the centrifugal swing begins. Centrifugal swing begins when the right elbow moves downswing. Rotation axis of these centrifugal swings are located at right leg, hip, shoulder axis. Three players' swings in open stance show constant center of gravity even though weight shift. Nishikori and Halep narrow their armpit angle just before starting centrifugal swing, while Federer begins centrifugal swing with a narrowing armpit angle. Three players' motion shows centrifugal swings. The moving distance of Dimitrov and Thiem are longer than that of Federer because centrifugal swing of both players appear in the middle of forward swing.